Welcome to today's episode. You may notice we're also portrait today, we're not landscape, and that is because I have an on-site news reporter for today's episode. Today's episode we're going to be talking about a new cable from Octopus Energy and Ohme, and this cable allows you to basically turn a dumb EV charger, an EVSE charger, into a smart charger using Octopus's API. So that can be either delayed using Octopus whenever it's greener, whenever it's cheaper, whenever the lower carbon on, or you could also do some other things with it. That was cut to Martin from EV News Daily, who's going to show us more on this cable today.
Hello, viewers of Nick's YouTube channel. My name is Martin from the EV News Daily podcast. Now, Nick couldn't be here today, so I'm making him a video for his channel. Hope this is okay, Nick, by the way. I'm here with someone you know. This is Fiona from Octopus Electric Vehicles. Hello, you have this amazing new technology that Nick wanted on his channel today, but he couldn't be here today. So this is a new cable by Ohme with Octopus Energy, with your agile tariff as well, and it charges cars cheaper and greener. That's super cool.
Yeah, it's brilliant. I mean, so we obviously have 100% renewable energy on Agile, but Agile basically takes half hourly energy prices that follow the wholesale market rate. And Ohme have developed a technology that can integrate with that and can automatically choose the right times to charge to get you the cheapest rates. And it's a cable, so it can work with any car and it can be retrofitted with any existing charge point with a socket, or it can be used with a commander socket or even your 3-pin plug.
Which is what I have at home. Don't tell anyone who sells EVSE. Come in with the camera. So this is it. Plugged in just a commando socket, can plug anywhere. This is the box down here. Thank you to Rebecca who's filming this, by the way. This is the box, and it just goes into your car as it normally would anywhere into your charger, which is dead clever. So if you can find out more, by the way, Nick will throw a bunch of... If you're wondering whose garage it is, by the way, it's because... This is a real life setting. This isn't in some kind of lab or something. This is technology being used right now, which you might be interested in getting hold of. Nick's going to throw some links down in the description below if you want to find out more about Octopus and Ohme. I hope this was okay, Nick. Is this all right? I'm squatting on your channel. By the way, check out the EV News Daily podcast. It's every single day. I know, right? 7 days a week. And it's your little 20-minute burst of EV news. Get it on all of your favourite podcast apps. That's a little plug on your channel. Thank you very much.
Thanks so much, Martin. That's great. Thank you very much. I know you're not used to video. You're more of a podcast man. If you haven't heard Martin's podcast, which I'm sure most of you have, it's fantastic daily brief news every single day of EV news. It is fantastically edited from a guy who used to work in the radio career, which you'd expect. He does it every single day. It's on every single podcast app known to man. I've also put a link at the end of the video to the YouTube channel where the audio is also stored, but I listen to it every single day on the way to work. It's nice and short, 15 minutes. He very, very rarely overruns 15 minutes. He keeps it the most condensed bit of information you can, and it's daily, and it's fantastic. So I fully recommend you do check out Martin's podcast every single day, EV News Daily. Give it a search. The cable, by the way, I will be doing a full test. Ohme and Octopus are sending me out a demo type 2 to type 2 cable, so I'm going to be trying it on my old Rolex, which is obviously a dumb charger. I'll test out all the functionalities, see what you can do with it. I'm going to try it with different cars, different manufacturers, make sure it works for all cars. As people know, sometimes certain cars can be fussy with cables, especially the Renault Zoe, so I will be testing it out with the Zoe. If it doesn't work or if there's anything wrong with it, I will report on it, but I'm expecting the cable to work absolutely fantastic. But I want to see how easy the user interfaces, so I will report back on that soon. There is links if you do wish to purchase it already down below, and also more information from Octopus's website. So thank you very much for checking out my channel this week. Don't forget to like it, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, and also make sure you subscribe to myself and also to Martin. Thanks very much, and I'll see you again next week. Goodbye.